Hello everyone, I am architect Yogesh Yadav, assistant professor at APJ School of Architecture and Planning, Greater Noida. The topic of my study is regional cultural landscapes, understanding the villages of Brush and their role in making Brush an important regional cultural landscape. The Indian cultural landscapes, the collection of religious, cultural and physical meanings associated with the geographical features of the place, with the collective memory rooted with active community engagement over the generations. Actually, it empowered the nature and made the geographical components metaphysical from physical. So in the Indian villages, there is the continuity of social setups, rich social context, and with the processes of festivals and religion, it gave birth to the localized cultures. So in the Brush region also, it is seen that almost all the villages, they derive their names from various sacred groups, and they are having a very strong cultural association with the legend of Krishna. And it is recognized as the regional cultural landscape with socio-cultural connect with its geographical features like hills, forests, ponds, groves. So the spaces, because of these cultural associations, they are actually the socio-cultural spaces, like spaces for organizing the pundals and the other celebrations in different parts of the year. So by exploring the cultural, historical and associative values of these villages and their setting in Brush, I'm trying to understand their indispensable role in making the Brush as an important cultural landscape. The cultural landscapes in India are shaped by the convergence of a memory, imagination, and the information, and it is seen as the repository of collective geographical perceptions. It is not only a physical setting of the geographical components, but it is the perception of cultural understanding of the people. So the Indian traditional knowledge and the perspectives, they are celebrated and practiced over the geography as canvas, where people interact with their surroundings. So the physical geography attains sacredness with the collective memory of the people and these associational values. Brush is not an area with clearly defined political or administrative boundaries. It is derived from the Sanskrit word braja. That means an enclosure of the herdsman and as a place where cows roam. As per the Rig Veda, it is the place where people pray for the cattle growth. In Brush, there is the place Govardhan, which is actually Govardhan, that literally means increasing cows and cattle. So the term Brush Bhumi is recognized as the name for the regional landscape, which is full of hills, forests, ponds, groves, and the river Yamuna there. The Brush region is seen as an important cultural landscape where the ascribed meanings and the associational values to the geography makes it sacred. So it is a religious landscape with mythical associations to the physical geography. Brush Bhumi falls in the golden triangle between the Jaipur, Delhi and Agra. And it is defined culturally, even though not so geographically. And this Brush region is spread over the Mathura district of Uttar Pradesh, Bharatpur district of Rajasthan, and the Hodal subdivision of Palwal district of Haryana. The whole region of Brush is believed to manifest the Leelas of Lord Krishna. So it is a very important thing to notice that the region is bound together by the legends of Lord Krishna, with each of the places associated with some specific Leela connected with him. If we talk about the historicity of the region, the historicity of Brush region goes beyond its present association with Krishna. The region has a rich history of more than 3,000 years. and it has been a seat of art and learning with the religions of Jainism, Buddhism, Hinduism, and Islam, and having a significant impact on its cultural development. The Mathura School of Indian Art, starting in the 2nd century BC, during a period in which the Buddhism, Jainism together with Hinduism, they flourished in India. And in the 16th century, it became the center of a Bhakti movement. Thus flourished under the liberal governance of Akbar and the Hindu ruler Raja Man Singh, and was established as a major pilgrimage center for Vaishnavites between the twin Mughal capitals of Delhi and Agra. Raja Man Singh erected the Govindadev temple at Vrindavan in 1590, which is a wonderful example of Hindu-Muslim architecture. So it is seen that the myths, legends, history, stories, they all intermix and coexist here. And there is the symbolic and symbiotic relationship that determines the cultural landscape of the region and makes the Braj unique. So here are the important forests, sub-forests, as per the various texts like Padma Purana, Varaha Puran, Bhavishya Puran, Vishnu Puran, and it is seen that many of the villages in Braj and the greater region, they derive their names from these various sacred groups. This regional cultural landscape of Braj is visited by the people in the form of a Braj Yatra, also called as Braj Parikrama, and there are two different routes called as inner parikrama path and outer parikrama path. So here is the map showing different villages in these routes, in these parikrama path. And all these villages are having their unique identity, and they are having the associational values to them. And they play a very important role in this Braj Yatra. So here, there is the, because of these associational values, the geographical components like the hills, they became metaphysical from physical. So here we can see the images of Sankari Khor, Fisalni Sila, the Govardhan Hill, and Bhojan Thali. So these are the geographical components in the region, and because of the associational values, they became metaphysical. All the pilgrimage centers of India, they are having their prototypes in Braj, like Kedarnath, Badrinath, Yamunotri, Gangotri. So the Braj is actually, it is the land of vibrant cultural traditions and festivals with a very unique kind of rural society. If we talk about the cultural celebrations in the different villages of Braj, so here are the images of Holi, Huranga, Laddu Holi, Latmar Holi of the villages Barsana and Nandgaon, Shadimar Holi in the village of Gokul, the famous Dauji Huranga in the village of Baldev, and of the Huranga of village Bathen. A very unique kind of Holi is organized every year in the villages of Falen and Jatwari, popularly known as Panda Mela. Panda means a priest. In this, a priest penetrates through the flames of Holika Dahin, and the event is associated with the story of Bhakt Prahlad and Holika. So there is a village Mukhrai, which is known as the Radha's mother's village, and this particular village is known for its special contribution of giving the Charkula dance to the Braj. And now the Charkula dance is the traditional folk dance of Braj. And in this dance, The veiled women, with balancing a large multi-tiered circular wooden pyramid on their heads, dance in varied steps on rasiyas, or the songs of Krishna. And this wooden pyramid is lighted with 108 oil lamps. Another important art of this Braj region is the Sanji art. And it is associated with Radha when they started making of Sanji for remembering Lord Krishna. In the villages of Braj, the unmarried girls used to make Sanji on the walls with cow dung paste, flowers, and the wheat flour, etc. Actually, this Sanji is derived from the Hindi word Sanj or Sandhya, the time of dusk. So there is a village it is named as Chaumuha. Chaumuha means Charmu, means the four faces of Brahma. So the village is having its name because of the associational values, because of the association with Lord Brahma. So it is the second temple of Brahma in the world after Pushkar in Rajasthan. And in the village Taroli, there is a temple of Swami Baba with a sacred pool, which is locally called as the Swami Baba Ka Kunda. And people believe that by bathing in this water body, it cures the skin diseases. So these villages with a lot of associational cultural values, they are at risk of transformations. The cultural heritage is connected to agricultural sites and areas influenced by the agricultural activity, and that is undergoing the significant changes caused by the influence of urban areas and suburbanization. Actually, the changes affect the traditional rural landscape because the dissonant objects appear in the urban areas that invade the cultural landscape of rural areas. It is difficult to stop the suburbanization processes that interfere with the rural environment, but the knowledge of degree of landscape transformations, it will help for the reasonable planning policies, space development, and appropriate management. So the rural areas in the municipality of Mathura, Vrindavan, and the industrial town of the region Kosikala, it is seen that they are undergoing the spatial changes. The villages neighboring to the urban areas, administrative centers, they are at most risk of transformations. So here is the image showing the Pali Kheda, Girdharpur, Bakalpur, Kisorpur, Manoharpur Dehat, and many more villages merged in the city. And now there are apartment towers and the housing societies that are dominating over the associational cultural geography. So there is very strong need to make more attention towards the villages and the role they can play for a continuous community engagement with the physical geography in a more holistic manner. There should be the initiatives for a conceptual transformation, the most importantly to mend the development gap between urban and rural areas. So there is need of rural revitalization, and this perspective leads to a distinctive approach to the concept of heritage and outlines a type of protection for the important regional cultural landscape. There is the need of further research for the field observations and the desk analysis for identifying and analyzing the physical, environmental, social, cultural values that can enhance the village experience quality. So there may be the listing of these villages on the basis of associated values and their significance as per the contribution in the regional cultural landscape as a whole. As of now, there is not the possibility of having the pasture lands, forests, sub-forests for cow grazing as described for the meaning of braja in many texts, but still there, if there are the villages, there is possibility of continuity in cultural practices and belongingness to the regional geography and the integration of cow and cattle based economy. Even many of the villages which got merged with the rapid growth of the cities and towns like Mathura and Kosi, they have lost their ponds and the natural catchment areas. So if we see the Vrindavan at present, so there is no difference between the present Vrindavan and any other city. It became concrete jungle. So without villages, there is no meaning of Braj. There is a very strong need to map the unique values of these villages, like the cultural, historical, ecological, social, and there is need to identify their issues and making the policies for the sustenance of these villages. It is seen that the cultural practices associated with the landscape is actually the way of living sustainably. So there is need to recognize the relationship between nature, culture, and humans mutually supporting each other and to reclaim the nature-culture linkages in this region. So these are the references taken for the study that can be referred for the further details. Thank you.